championship golf courses, one being the Palm course, the other being the Mountain course. We have a 12-hole par 3 course that is lit up for night play, and a 9-hole natural grass putting course that's also lit for night play.
Use the water efficiently and responsibly. Obviously, the water's a huge issue in Nevada.
With using affluent water, we're dealing with a lot of salts and bicarbonates and nitrates. Being on affluent water and all the nitrates that we're dealing with on a daily basis, every time we turn a sprinkler on, we're applying a certain amount of nitrogen, and that's obviously greatly affects our fertility program. The biggest challenge, I think, moving forward will be potential water restrictions and government regulations, and so that's one of the main reasons I'm using POGO now, is so when the time comes when we have to defend our use of water, we'll have years of data built up showing that we're responsible water users and we're not wasting water.
Everybody across the valley right now is struggling. We just can't find labor. We're running 5 guys short, and people come in the door to apply for jobs, and they see what the job is, what it pays, and they're like, no, I'm not going to do that. That seems to be the case not only here in Vegas, I'm sure it's the same around the country, but when construction is good, it's tough for us to get employees. So it all kind of goes with the economy. I bought a POGO, I think it was my first year here, one of the original models. We have two of the new ones and one of the old ones. And I plan on buying probably and maybe two more next year, because I think we need 5 or 6 here to really do what we want to do.
We'll get out and do our sampling in the first 2 to 3 hours on the greens in the morning. On a 6,000 square foot green, we're probably taking anywhere between 18 and 25 samples, depending on the time of year and kind of how we feel the conditions are.
I have a couple of old cell phones that we use strictly for the POGO, so they can take that with them. And we have a couple of iPads that we use for it. We'll actually pull the visual insight up on the computer in the assistant's office so they can look at it at any time.
All of our assistants know how to use the POGO system.
Because when we give it to our setup guys while they're out there cutting cups, then they start asking what numbers we're looking for, what the numbers mean, and they take an interest in it. And they eventually take ownership of it, so it's nice. It makes them feel more involved and kind of in the know of what's going on and why we're doing what we're doing.
But I think the biggest thing for us with the color coding on the mapping is it's relatable to everybody on the crew. So, while there's only, maybe 4 or 5 guys that really use the POGO here that understands the numbers, or at least most of the numbers, everybody can understand that red needs water or red needs aerifying. Using the POGO allows us to see what is underneath the turf versus just looking at an area, seeing that it's thin, knowing that something's wrong, but not knowing what it is. Where with the POGO, it gives us the insight ahead of time to do what we need to do to resolve the issue before we see it. The insight that it gives you, being able to relate science to the grass, whereas, just recently, a few years ago, we were going out with soil probes and just filling up the moisture in the soil and believing that the turf was getting what it needs. Now that we can correlate numbers with the conditions we see in the field and actually be able to predict, at what percentage of moisture we need to water, is a more efficient way for us to water and provides better playing conditions for our customers.
We used a small spectrum EC meter, and it was basically the soil probes. Basically, I was doing this, but it was all handwritten. So we'd have nine zones per green.
Yeah.
We'd take the 9 samples, kind of write it down, and it got us started. But obviously, this is so much more advanced and easier to manage versus, handwriting. Somebody that sometimes you can read, sometimes you can't.
Before we had the visual insight, we had printed out our own maps of the greens, and we had sectioned it off into 7, 8, or 9 zones, depending on the size of the green, and we would actually manually write the percentages in. obviously with the inside, all that's done. So it's, you know, labor savings on that side, but also it's just allowed us to be more consistent and take more samples from each green to get a better snapshot actually what's going on. Before I had the POGO, we would just needle tine the greens about every 30 days, all calendar based. Whereas with the POGO, I've been able to stretch that out in a lot of cases, which saves me on labor, and I still know I'm doing the right thing for the turf. Having the numbers and putting a science to it, we've been able to stretch that to sometimes 6 and even 7 weeks. So we're able to reduce our water usage on a nightly basis, also reduce it by having less flushings through the year, and produce better playing surfaces for our guests. We go out with the soil probe, and we'll do it the old-fashioned way, and I tell him to, after he looks at the sample, I ask him to tell me how much water he would put on it. And then we pull out the POGO and take a sample from that exact spot. And the majority of the time, it doesn't need water. So it really shows them why we do what we do. When we just used to use the soil probes, guys that are hand watering in the morning, you know, it was pretty normal for them to overwater in the morning. That way they wouldn't have to come back later and add more water, drag the hose out of the cart again. Where now with the POGO, a lot of times they don't even have to pull the hose out because we're at our target number. When we do our samples, I can print out the color-coded map and hand it to our hand waters, and they know only to water the red spots on the map. So it's cut our hand watering by probably close to 70%. Instead of having to go and check every green, they can just go to the 6 or 7 greens that we know need the supplemental irrigation.
The biggest thing for me learning just from what we've done so far is the greens really don't dry out as much or as quick as I thought they would. So from that perspective, we're using water more efficiently and only applying, you know, when we know it absolutely needs it.
So we're able to extend our days where we don't water. So we're saving water and being more responsible.
The mapping with the color coding really helps us. It shows traffic patterns, you know, especially on the walk-on and walk-offs of the greens. So if we don't have time to get out and needle time the entire green, we can take the map, I can give it to one of my guys with an aerifier, they can go out and just hit those high traffic areas, which really helps us, especially on those walk-on and walk-off areas. So we're able to create better conditions with actually less labor being used just by hitting certain areas, which makes the greens more consistent.
I mean, I like looking at the trending. It helps me to plan aerification and flushing versus just going by the calendar. More science versus what we've always done, which I think is the worst term in the golf industry.
We'll formulate our program on the greens, and we'll eventually carry that over. Once we get it dialed in and understand exactly what all the numbers mean, we'll transition that to our tees and then to our fairways, which we know in our fairways is where we'll see the biggest water savings because it's the greatest amount of area.
Once we get our greens dialed in, we move to fairways, we start to dial that in. I expect to be able to cut our water use from fairways by probably 15 or 20%. You know, when you're using as much water as we do here, that's a lot of dollars that's going to go to the bottom line.
A lot of people always ask me my thoughts about the POGO, and I just tell them directly that, you know, in the last 25 or 30 years, there's been two products that I feel like has changed our industry for the better, one being Primo and the other being the POGO.
That's good to hear. Yeah, that's good.